Hello once again and welcome to another video. This time I'll be taking a look at a game by the name of Particulars. This game is currently on early access on Steam. It currently describes itself as being in alpha state at the moment. The game has been up since around the 6th of December 2013 and has slowly been receiving updates. It is developed by SeeThrough Studios, a small indie development team based out of Sydney, Australia. The publisher for the game is Surprise Attack. Links for both will be at the description below this video. At a first glance, this would appear to be their first game, and it is their first game that appears on the Steam service. However, if you head over to their main site, you will find that under other projects, there are two other games by the name of Unstopperbot and Flatland Fallen Angle. These do not show up on the Steam page by the developer themselves if you search by developers, so these may at the moment just be technical alphas or in pre-alpha states, I'm not sure. However, these are other projects that they are currently working on or have worked on in the past. If you're curious to know what else has been published by Surprise Attack, there are three other games on the Steam service at the moment. They are OTTTD, a tower defense slash RTS game with RPG elements, supposedly featuring some of the weirdest creatures in the multiverse, according to the Steam page description. The other games are Ventiginous Golf, if you pronounce it that way. It's a golfing game, obviously. It's very unusual indeed if you look at the screenshots. It's very, very detailed. It describes itself as a physics-based first-person exploratory mini-golf game set in a Victorian world. It certainly does look very beautiful on the screenshots, and this is something I might actually play in the future. However, onto their third and final game, it is called Screen Cheat. It is a split-screen multiplayer FPS, another one of course, but in this one everyone is invisible, and the aim of the game is to cheat to win. So if you remember back in the days of when you might have played split-screen with your friends on the TV, you essentially play like that. However, this appears to be in quarters, so there are four, or at least in the screenshot, you see four different views at once, yours and three other players. So you see where they are, you see what they're doing, and it's sort of a game about who can fake each other out, because everyone can see what the other person is doing, so you have to fake out your moves and try and get them to think you're doing something that you're actually not. However, getting back to the game in hand, it describes itself on the Steam page as a game that features a unique combination of arcade action and puzzle gameplay, which is set in the world of subatomic particles, in which you take control over a single quark. You may also pronounce this quark, depending on where you're from. I prefer Quark, as in like the character from Deep Space Nine, if any of you remember that one. In the game, your goal is to negotiate the fundamental forces of the universe. Other particles will come along and push and pull you like little bullies as you simply go about your business. You will always be on the brink of losing control and being dragged towards annihilation. The game features a total of 50 levels across 4 chapters. The game is available on all three systems, that being Windows, Mac and Linux operating systems. There is no standard options menu inside the game. It is all done by a configuration window when you first launch the game that will allow you to choose between a variety of resolutions and an option that will allow you to go into a windowed mode. For me, the highest resolution available was 1920 by 1080. I am not sure if the game does support higher resolutions or not. 1920 by 1080 is my native resolution on my monitor, so it may just be a case that the game simply only displays up to the native resolution. It may support higher, it may not. I do not know. This is something that you might have to look at yourself. This might affect you if you do have a higher res monitor and a resolution above standard 1080p. Also available from the pre-game launcher is a set of three graphical preset options, these being fastest, good and best. Not the best selection I would like to see. I would have liked to have seen individually adjustable graphical options. However, the game is not really that graphically demanding, so this shouldn't be a problem. It ran just fine on my main PC and also on my laptop. On the laptop it was between 58 and 60fps, so it shouldn't be a problem for most people. The game also features fully rebindable keys. You can bind yourself both a primary set as well as a secondary set if you would like. This is a very nice option to have. You may also use a controller. The game does feature partial controller support, according to the Steam page. I did not use a controller, however, so I cannot really comment on to how supported or not it actually is and to any issues that you might actually encounter. But then once you do launch into the game, you will find another options menu. This is just for audio. There are a set of four audio sliders. These are for master volume, sound effects, music, and voiceover, which in this case is the narration that you have during the game. These sliders scale from 0 to 1 in increments of 0.01, 0.02, all the way up to 99. So there is a good level of feedback available on these sliders, so they're not just arbitrary with no obvious or measurable scale. These are quite detailed and shouldn't present a problem if you're trying to find specific audio levels for recording purposes or streaming purposes, etc. One thing to note about the narration, it seems to describe personal experiences of one or more people and their family. Whether these are real experiences or not, I do not know. Why they are there as well, I'm not sure. They do not sort of fit with the story, but then the game doesn't tend to have a story per se. It's more of an experience. So I don't really know how to interpret these either. They also tend to jump around as well in time. They're not linear. So if anyone out there does know what they are trying to say or express overall and feelings they are trying to provide, please feel free to let me know in the comments below, because I would genuinely like to know on this. If we look at the movement controls, the movement handles quite fine with mouse and keyboard, which is what I did use. You don't really use the mouse for control. The mouse is used as a means to slow down time. When the cursor enters the main screen area in which your particle that you control moves in, time will slow down, giving you the ability to see where everything is moving slowly and where it is going, which gives you time to plan ahead for perhaps a change in a direction, as movement in this isn't instantaneous. The way the movement system in this game appears to work is momentum based. So you will gain a forward directional momentum and you will gradually build it up. There does appear to be a maximum speed that you can achieve. If you then wish to change or alter your course, you will then gain a momentum in that direction. This is why you can't just suddenly stop to avoid things. You must be aware of your situations and surroundings at all times. How other objects will interact with each other, how they will bounce off walls or other particles around you, and when a group of them splits or gets destroyed, where they will go. The mechanics based on how you'll interact with other particles while moving and bouncing is physics based, that is built on real world physics, according to the Steam page. So just to sum up really, some sort of personal feelings on the game. Early on it is quite slow going, not really getting any enthusiasm as I play. It may get better later on, but the first few levels on chapter 1 up to level 15 didn't really excite me too much. I was interested to see what the next introduction would be in terms of mechanics on each level. Once you get past all these introductions and it begins to blend and combine some of them together, I feel that the game may open up more and become a lot more fun to play and interesting, assuming that it does. Again, I don't know, I only got up to the first 15 levels of chapter 1 and it was still introducing new things and ideas at this point. It is important to bear in mind that this is also just a quick overview and first look at the game, not a complete review, so I don't know how the game does fully develop over the course of the entire game. I only have experience of the first 15 levels in chapter 1. What I will say though, however, is that the soundtrack itself is very calming. It also appears to be a bit haunting and mysterious. It feels more like I'm in space flying around rather than being a particle at a subatomic level if you just close your eyes and listen to the music and see where it takes you. It actually reminds me a lot of the music from Starbound when you used to explore each planet. Overall, I feel it is quite a very good soundtrack. If you are looking for a price of this game, there is a demo available on Steam that goes up to level 15 in Chapter 1. If you would like to buy the game at present on Steam, the standard edition is £6.99. There is a supporters pack available which includes the game, soundtrack, wallpaper and digital art book. This is £14.99. It does state, however, that bonuses will be delivered as they are finished, so if, for instance, the art book isn't fully complete yet, you will receive this when it is finished. There is also a devotee pack available. This includes everything that you get in the supporters pack, as well as in-game developer commentary DLC, the How We Got Here pack, which is a collection of their early games and videos chronicling the development of SeeThrough Studios, and you will also get a special thank you in the game's credits. Once again, the bonuses will be delivered as they are finished, and this pack will set you back $29.99. Personally, I'd grab the supporter pack as it includes the soundtrack, which personally I feel is quite a very nice soundtrack. There is also the option to buy yourself a 4-pack of the game,